Bye. So go on, go home.
Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga tu reino. Hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Amén.
Guess it's true, I'm not good, I don't understand. But I still need love, cause I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay with me. Why am I so emotional? No, it's not a good look and some self-control. Deep down I know this never works. But you can lay with me so it doesn't hurt. Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all.
Like every day, wanna be with you, but you're. car outside, KB8. KB8, you're blocking somebody in. KB8-9090. Thank you.
Will all except the family please stand? All except the family please stand. I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. She that believeth in me shall never die, and whoever shall believeth in me will always live. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. And I'll see him for myself, and will not behold not another. We brought nothing into this world. It is certain we can carry nothing out of it. The Lord gave, and now the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, Lord, teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. And as it was in the beginning, as now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. You may be seated. Shall we pray? And now, eternal God, we ask that your Holy Spirit will descend on this space. Although it's a space of mourning and bereavement, because Musette Cox believed in Jesus, it's an announcement that she will have eternal life. She has been resurrected. And we ask, O God, that you would bless this service to your will and to your purpose. We thank you for the friends that have come, the co-workers that have come. They referred to her as Lady M. And of course, we thank you for the family that has strength enough to stand with pride and with conviction. So God bless us now and keep us in the palm of your hand as we come to remember our dear friend, our mother, grandmother, Musette Frances Williams-Cox. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Scripture will now be read by Minister Janice Qualls and Reverend Jerome Payne. And then Reverend Guy DuPont will come and lead us to God's throne of grace with a prayer of comfort. Let the church say amen.
Praise the Lord. I'll be reading from the book of Proverbs, chapter 31, 10 through 15. An excellent wife, who can find? For her worth is far more above jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and she will not lack or gain. She will not have no lack or gain. She does him good and not evil. All the days of her life, she looks for wool and flax. and works with her hands in delight. She is like a merchant ship. She brings her food from afar. She rises also while it is night and gives food to her household and portions to her maidens. The word is already blessed. May it be a blessing on the hearer and the doer.
Praise the Lord, church. I'll be reading from John, the 14th chapter, verse 1 through 4. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. The word of God is blessed. John 14, 1 through 4.
Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we approach your throne of grace and mercy in the precious name of Jesus our Christ. Lord, we want to thank you, first of all, for allowing us to see another day of life, health, and strength, and in our right mind with the activity of our limbs. Lord, we call on your name now. We first realize that you're too good to do evil, and you're too wise to make a mistake. We don't question your work, Lord. But we pray, God, for this bereaved family and friends, that you would give them strength, comfort their hearts. For Lord, when the crowd is gone, let us remember the good times of our beloved sister. God, we pray that your spirit will move in this place. Bless the man of God as he shall come to deliver your word of inspiration. Again, O God, I pray that you comfort this family and their friends, and even me, Lord. But Lord, I got to tell you, thank you for your multiplicity of mercy and your conglomerates of grace. God, you've been so mighty good to us. We praise your name, Lord. If we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't praise your name enough. For you're a God that changeth not. You're still on a throne with all power. You don't slumber, you don't sleep. You're the same God yesterday, today, and forever. And we praise your holy name. We bless your holy name. We lift your name. We exalt your name. These blessings we ask in the name of Jesus our Christ. And let every heart say amen.
Minister Sales will now come with a selection of comfort for the family.
Yeah.
Amen. We're going to continue our program with remarks. We're going to ask the first person to speak is Deacon Orlando Leopold from Brown Memorial Baptist Church. And we're reminded the family has requested that you would limit your remarks to 2 minutes. Somebody say amen. Amen. Thank you, Deacon.
Good afternoon, family, pastor, associates, spiritual board members. Good afternoon, congregation, pastor, associates, spiritual board members. We come to offer our condolences to the family of our queen, Musette Frances William Cox. We ask that, Lord, that you would just keep them in their time of mourning and strengthen them and let them know, Lord, that there is no pain that you cannot cure. We ask that, Lord, you would just help them at this moment, that they'll stay together as a family. As I look at the itinerary, all I see is smiling faces of the family, all the good times. We ask that y'all remember this and help and strengthen each other. I'll ask all the members and the spiritual board of Brown Memorial Baptist Church, please stand, if you're not already standing. We just want you to know that you're not alone, that if there's anything that we can do as your church family, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us. And we ask that Jesus will keep y'all and comfort y'all in this time of bereavement. Thank you.
Amen. Is there anybody else? Come on, Imani. Let's give Imani a round of applause.
Hello, everybody. I just want to thank everyone for coming and celebrating my mom. My mom was a very conservative, private person. And as we all know, she's very secretive. So she didn't really want everybody to know that she had breast cancer. So with her battling cancer, it was private. You know, it was very private, and it was very hard, you know, because seeing her, you know, like, just go through the different stages of cancer, because I didn't understand it at first. It just happened so fast. She was diagnosed in September, and then November, December, January came, and then April, she's just not here anymore. But, you know, like, to know my mother is to know that she's a lioness for her cubs. She loves us, you know, and I'm just grateful that she's at peace, because seeing this fight that she just took on, it was not easy. Like, literally seeing her last few weeks in the hospital with tubes in her throat, not being able to get up, knowing my mom is an independent person. Like, you can't tell her anything. She literally, like, it started with, first she started with her cane, then her walker. Then, like, to be bedbound and considered, like, disabled to where you can't move, that's hard for a person that was just, like, able to use the bathroom on their own, to have someone have to wipe you. I know it was so hard for her. So, you know, like, at first I was like, Dad, you know, like, my mom's in the hospital. I got to run back and forth. It's stressful, but I don't want to complain, you know, because we get one mom. But now it's like, I'm happy that she's at peace, and she doesn't have to fight this fight anymore. And she fought as long as she could, and now she's protecting us in heaven. So I'm just thankful that God has her, and she's at peace. That's all.
Amen.
If anybody else wants to speak, you guys could talk. This is my mom's friend, Ms. Lillian.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. This is a homegoing service. This is not a funeral as we know it. Sister Musette, my friend, my sister friend, was saved, sanctified, and filled. So she's not going to where we don't know where. She is going to heaven. So we should be rejoicing, because if you're saved, you're going to see her again. So we can't sit here like this is the cemetery, because it's not. This is the house of God, and we should be lifting our hands. We should be telling God thank you. We should be celebrating this beautiful soul. Musette Cox was my sister friend. If you understand what it means to be a true friend, this lady was a true friend, an encourager, a supporter, somebody that was always in your corner, somebody that always had your back, and somebody that I, in all the years that I've ever been in her company, we talked all day, every day, have never said an unkind word about not one person. So I find it robbery to sit there and not say something good about my friend. When I tell you, this was a beautiful woman. Yeah, quiet, but powerful behind the scenes. This lady pushed me, and I just graduated again with another degree, a degree from seminary. I looked up during graduation, and Musette was there, and I was like, Musette, how did you get here? Like, how did you even find out? But nothing hindered her from supporting somebody she loved. I don't care what it was. I would be in Long Island, Jersey. What Musette would be there with that walker. Like, Musette, how did you get here? So I'm telling you, the Bible says he that should have friends must first show themselves friendly. So if you don't have too many friends, what is that saying about you? Everybody should have a friend like Sister Musette, one that you'll look up, and she's there to support you. I love you, my sister. I don't know how I'm going to go on. Thinking about you is just hard for me. But we laughed, we joked, we cut up, and that's what I'm going to remember. So family, Brown family, be encouraged. Musette's family, be encouraged. We are praying for you, and we all have your back.
Good morning or afternoon, everybody. I was debating on whether or not I would come up and say anything, because this has really been a very emotional time. I've been friends with Musette since freshman year in high school, and she was definitely my best friend. We were best friends. She was very private. I mean, I knew the situation from the beginning. And I'm sorry, y'all. But just like her other friend was saying, she loved God. She was a believer, definitely had a relationship with him. And because of that, I know that I'll see her again, you know. I know that I'll see her again. This side, the natural side, of course, we know that we're all still in our natural bodies, so we feel the loss. We feel the loss on this side, but she's with God. She's with him. So we know that if we have a relationship with God as well, that we'll see her again. I did get an opportunity to come down to see her when she was in the hospital on Resurrection Sunday. So I was able to encourage her in the fact that we know that God is a miracle worker. We know that he could have raised her up and healed her, because he is that. He is a healer. But even in encouraging her, I was able to, because I know that she has a relationship. Encourage her in the fact that either way that the situation went, she was a winner. You know, whether or not God chose to have her here with us a little while longer or take her on to be with him, in either situation, she won. So we can be encouraged in the fact that she won. And if we continue to live and live for God, that we'll again see her again. But I do want to encourage the family, Amani, Donovan, Dre, her grandchildren, those of us, all of us who loved her and shared our life with her, that we can remember and just think on the memories. You know, time passes, love remains. You know, that's what's going to keep us and hold us together. Remember the good times. Remember the good times and remember the good times. You know, ask God to heal us so that we'll be able to love on each other and move forward in this. And he'll do it. He'll do it. He'll do it. I'm sad. My heart is broke. My heart is broke. But as I stated, I know that because he is, that I'll see her again. I'll see her again.
Giving honor unto God, who's the head of my life, and I know he is the head of Musette's life as well. This is the Excellence family where her son Andre attended, and we come out in full force for each other. We stand here today. We stand here today in unison with the family. Andre, Donovan, Imani, we love you. We loved your mother. She was a sister, she was a friend, and we miss her dearly. I remember we met her 20 years ago, because Excellence is now 20 years old. 2004, we came in, most of us came in not knowing each other, and as we grew to become friends. We were acquaintances, friends, and now we're family. At any time, if you need us, we will be here for you. As you can see, we have teachers here. We have staff here. That's how much she meant to us. I will miss the conversations that we used to have about our children, about life. There's a chair that I always, for some reason, sat in when she would call or I would call her. I looked at that chair this morning, and I know it's not gonna happen anymore, but I know she's in good hands. When I last saw her, it was Good Friday, and I just could not believe this was the same person that I had spoken to 3 weeks prior. We love her. We are here for you, we love you, and we trust that God will continue to keep you. Live in the legacy that your mother left. Live in the legacy that your mother left. She loved God, she cherished God, she adored God, she praised him, and she prayed all the time for you. Continue to carry that legacy. It is important. If you want to see your mother again, it is very, very important that you follow in her footsteps. Otherwise, you will never see her again. God keep you. God bless you. and may you continue to live your life in the goodness of Jesus. Thank you.
Wasn't that classy? When they all came walking down the aisle, I said, I hope not all of them are going to speak. Amen. We have one more person who's going to come.
Good afternoon, everybody. Praise the Lord. It's not easy for me. Myself and Musette has been friends since we were toddlers. In all our lives, we both kept each other encouraged. When I wanted to give up on my life after losing my sister a few years ago, she kept me encouraged. She tried to stay in contact with me every day. But just growing up together, we just became sisters. This is my only sister living. But Musette, she just, oh gosh. She was a godly woman, that's one thing I can say. We prayed together all the time, all the time. When I became one of Donovan's godmothers, I tried my best to keep her encouraged, to keep him, you know, focused on God and life. I don't know, this is hard for me, I'm sorry. I'm gonna miss her. Every family function I had, she had, I was there. I'm just totally speechless, but family, stay encouraged. Please stay together. Don't let this be the last time you all see each other. I know what it feels like after a loss, but please, by any means necessary, stay together. I love y'all. You know I'm just a call away. I will always be there. Thank you.
Georgie, Donovan, Dre, and Imani, you know your mother she was like a sister to me also. She's been there for me. Even your grandparent, your grandmother was there. I know when my mother when my mother had passed, who was there? Miss Williams. Also have to say, stay together, love one another, and always remember your mother was there for you, all of you. I love you. If you ever need me, I'm here. I'm still here in Brooklyn. I'm just a phone call away. And make sure you get my number, okay?
Hello, everyone. My name is Joelle. So in order to not cry, I have to kind of laugh a little bit here. So I've known Musette all my life. That's my sister. I've, you know, helped out a lot with just planning all this. So I just want to thank the church, Pastor Miller, Miss Gant, Miss Roslyn, Miss Sheila, Miss Lisa for helping with the live streaming, and just any, you know, relatives or anyone that reached out that helped in any way. Honestly, I'm really grateful for you. You know, I'm gonna miss her. I see it as she is now with my mom and they are celebrating together. I just wanna kinda say a story just to kinda keep it on a light tip and just to laugh a little bit so I don't cry. Musette was like a second mom to me. So all her friends who knew her when she was in her younger years, I just want to apologize if she had to bring the annoying little sister with her around. Hopefully I wasn't too annoying. And I really love her and miss her. And I used to be like, Mom, I mean, Musette, you know, because she just always had me with her. And I just always remember being with her, or even in high school, going to her house and taking the bus to school from there, and her fussing with, you know, my mom and dad because I didn't know how to take public transportation until I was like 14 years old, and I had to learn how to get to high school alone. So she used to fuss with them on that and like show me how to get to school by train and bus and all the different ways. So I'm just gonna always cherish like all those little stories and, you know, love her. And honestly, she loved her Brown family, the church family. I knew she was very heavily, you know, participated in church and into the committee. So I just want to thank everyone, you know, from the church that helped with any part of making this happen. And I'm sure that she appreciates it. And thank you everyone who came out and turned up. That's it.
Hi, I'll be very quick. Lizette and I shared breast cancer, and I'm here to say that we're in the group, sister supporting group sisters, and we're gonna miss her from sister supporting sisters. Amen.
Hello everybody, I will be super brief. I am Khadijah Akeem Cox, I am Andre's wife. So I met what I call her Mama Love, and I call her Mew Mew. And I met her about 5 years ago. And I just wanted to highlight on a comment that Imani made. Imani said, you only get one mother.
Sorry. And I was blessed to get two. So
I wanted to come up here and say that I was blessed to get two. I was one of the few people that were blessed to have two mothers. And I'm sorry, I'm usually better with public speaking, but when we chatted, because, you know, sometimes she would give me the tea, and I loved talking with her because she was super encouraging. I'm currently in my first year of my PhD program, and every time we spoke, she would ask me how my classes were going. I'm gonna miss having that person to check up on me, who was another mother. And although I didn't have more time with her to grow our relationship as mother-in-law and daughter-in-law, she'll always have a super special place in my heart. And I wanted to say this one thing that is in Islam, right? There's a hadith, and in the hadith, it's your mother, your mother, your mother, and then your father. And I love her because she was my mother too.
Good afternoon. My name is Adrienne Spivey, and I was a co-worker. I worked at the Office of Non-Public and Charter Schools with Musette, and we send our greatest condolences to the family on behalf of our office. I just wanted to share that Musette was, as someone mentioned earlier, when you look in the brochure, you see smiles. And when we walked into our office, the first person we see, it's Musette, and she always greeted us with a smile. I've been working with Musette, when I sat and thought about it, for about 15 years. And you don't realize the impact and the depth of relationships until someone is gone. And so when I came today, I didn't expect to be one of the criers, but I was. I just wanted to say thank you for lending her to us. Thank you for supporting her through whatever she may have went through as a member of our office. Thank you, God, for placing in her the joy and the
love that she shared with us. She was a member of our Sunshine Committee, and it was great the way she brought everyone together to enjoy life, to celebrate the different holidays that we celebrate, because we're a very diverse office. So I just wanted to speak and let you know that we loved Musette in the Office of Non-Public Schools and Charter Schools, and that she will truly be missed.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is George Williams, and it's my sister. And I'm gonna miss our talks and our laughter. I'm gonna miss that smile. But you know, I know my sister, and she'll be like, you know, why is everybody here making a fuss about me? Yeah, I'll be all right, I'm okay. That's my sister. Didn't want to worry. But, you know, Imani, Donovan, Andre, I'm here. I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, showing their love and support. You know, today we're family. There's no friends, co-workers, we're all family. And if she touched your heart, she'll always touch your heart. I don't know, this is not easy. My mother and now my sister, this is really hard, but I thank you all for coming out. Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
In reflection, I took a moment this morning to think about my friend, my sister, and I just first began to thank God for Musette Cox. The relationship that we had, the love that we shared, and the time that God allowed us on this earth to be together. As I continue to think about the moments, because as Evangelist Lillian mentioned earlier, this is a homegoing service. Because at the end of the day, the text that comes to my mind is, from our labor to great reward. And anybody who is a believer and a child of the Almighty God understands that. That after this, there is a reward. Amen. We don't know the day, we don't know the hour, but it is and is sure to come. So I just want to reflect for a moment on the times that I spent with her. Back in, I want to say 2013, the Lord had called me to establish a women's Bible study group. It was established so that we may grow the women of God according to the word. And I said to her, she was one of the founding members, and I said, but we need a place. We need a holding place. She said, I got this. And we stayed in this beautiful place that she established here in Bed-Stuy until COVID. Anything that I needed of her or asked of her, she was right there. We spent hours on the phone just talking about everything, sometimes even on lunch hour. I know some of her coworkers are here, but this is just the real of it. So I stand here before you to just remember the moments that I will treasure. Regardless of what we go through, this is just really the beginning, amen? This is not an end, this is the beginning. And I say to the family, be encouraged. And there was someone else who spoke earlier as it relates to, if you want to see your mother again, allow her life to be the guidance, the role model that you take. God bless you. Sister Marilyn Brooks, Marilyn Brown, our church clerk, she will come now with the announcements and the resolutions. Deaconess Diane Shelton, praise the Lord. Let's give her a hand as she comes.
Good afternoon, family. Good afternoon, Brown. My name is Deaconess Diane Shelton. I will be reading some of the cards that were sent, the condolence cards. This card says, may God comfort you in your time of loss May God give you his peace in every way and cover you in his love throughout these sad and difficult days. To Imani and family, with heartfelt sympathy and love, Deaconess Ida Maya and family. With sympathy in the loss of your loved one, may tender thoughts of your loved ones lie forever within your heart and blossom into the most beautiful memories. With deepest sympathy, the Senior Missionary Society of Brown Memorial. For every joy that passes, something beautiful remains. May the joys you knew and the times you shared help comfort you in this time of grief. We are praying for your family, again, the Spiritual Board of Brown Memorial Baptist Church. No one can say they know what you're going through right now. Hope there is comfort in knowing others share your sadness and care about you. The 40 Plus Ministry, that was a ministry that Musette was in from the beginning. Let the love all around you and the love within you soothe your grief and pain. And that's from me, Deaconess Diane Shelton. Will all the members of Brown please stand as I read the resolution? Sorry. Yes, see. Whereas God, in his infinite and divine wisdom, has deemed it his will to call our beloved sister Musette Cox from labor to reward. We, the officers and members of Brown Memorial Baptist Church, humbly submit to his will, knowing that God knows what is best. Sister Cox joined Brown Memorial under the leadership of Reverend Clinton Miller. She was a faithful member and she served the Lord well. She was a member of the Missionary Society, the Education Ministry, and the 4060 Ministry. Musette was one of the founding members of the Sisterhood Ministry. We thank God for allowing her to be a part of our church family. In appreciation of such a life, we, the members of Brown Memorial, wish to extend our deepest sympathy to her family and friends. So today, we gather not to say goodbye, but a fond farewell to our loved one. Therefore, let it be known to all assembled that yet another link from the Brown Memorial Baptist Church chain of fellowship and service has been removed. We pause to celebrate the life and Christian witness of Sister Cox and look forward to the great day when we shall meet again. Be it resolved on this 17th day of April in the year of our Lord 2024, a copy of this resolution will be given to the family and a copy shall be entered into the archives of Brown Memorial. Humbly submitted, the Brown Memorial Baptist Church family, Reverend Clinton M. Miller, pastor. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, church. Come on, let's praise the Lord, because this is not a service for the dead, this is for the living. Just before I read the obituary, I'm looking at verse 13 from chapter 13, the 1 Corinthians. And now abideth faith, hope, and love. These three, but the greatest of these is love. Sister, friend, Musette was loved. She not only loved, but she gave love. Amen? And I have the privilege where she asked me one day, she said, you know, Pastor, I've gotten to know you over the years. And she said, I'd like you to be a family member. And it's an honor to be included in your family. So if you need me at any time or whatever, you can call me. Amen? Now, Minister Sales, this is Musette. My heart belongs to you.
My heart belongs to you. No one else can do the things you do or the things you've done. My heart belongs to you. Father, my heart belongs to you. No one else can do the things you do or the things you've done. My heart belongs to you. Jesus Christ, my heart belongs to you. No one else can do the things you do or the things you've done. My heart belongs to you. The obituary. Musette Frances Williams-Cox, a warm spirit at heart, born May 21st, 1969, in Brooklyn, New York. Her parents are James Jordan and the late Alice Williams and George Williams. She was raised by George Williams and found her biological father, James, in 2022, in which they began to build a positive relationship as he welcomed her with open arms as his found daughter. Musette attended and graduated from Abraham Lincoln High School. She was an active basketball player for Lincoln and frequently beat her brother George William II when they played against each other. He'll never want to admit that, but it's true. She then received her associate degree. She worked several jobs until she landed a secretarial position with the New York City Department of Education, in which she dedicated over 25 years. She built great relationship with coworkers, and they often referred to her as Lady M. To some, she was more like a sister, and they had so much respect for her. She would often give them guidance and show compassion and comfort when needed. Musette shared three children with her former spouse, Andy Cox, Donovan, her eldest, Imani, the middle child, and Andre, the youngest. She took immense pride in being their mother and cherished her role as grandmother to Adonis and Jamali. Jamai, affectionately calling them her cubs. Her love extended beyond her immediate family to include her extended relatives. She cherished moments when the family would come together and spend quality time with one another. Devoted to her faith, Musette participated in Brown Memorial Baptist Church for over 20 years. Reverend Miller, her pastor, held a special place in her heart, and she cultivated meaningful relationships with fellow church members. The support she received from her church community meant a great deal to her. Among her favorite prayers was the Serenity Prayer. After a tough battle fighting cancer, Musette peacefully passed away on April 4, 2024, at Bellevue Hospital at the age of 54. Even amidst the sorrow we feel now, Musette would desire for us to honor her life by cherishing fond memories and sharing laughter. Musette is preceded in death by her parents, Alice and George Williams, as well as her aunt, Portia McCoy. She is survived by Andy Cox, her former partner, her daughter, Imani Cox, and two sons, Donovan Harris and Andre Cox, Khadijah. Additionally, she leaves behind her brother, George William II, sister Jewel Powell Martin, two grandsons, Adonis Harris and Jamai Little, and a nephew, Kareem Williams. Her surviving first cousins include Saul McCoy, Keisha Rooks, Kirk, and Sean Moore Levi, along with numerous other relatives and friends who will cherish her memory. A mother to some and a friend to many, Musette will be remembered as a kind-hearted person she is. as the kind-hearted person she is.
God bless you, Minister Sales. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise for Minister Sales. Amen. To Andy Cox, to Amani, Donovan, Andre, to all the relatives who have come from far and near. There's a scripture, and we won't keep you long. There's a repass following this service. It comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 1. And it reads, "For we know that if the earthly house of our tabernacle be dissolved, we have another building from God, a house not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens." Musette had a bright, radiant smile. And whenever she was in the room, you knew she was there because the smile was that bright. And even, I'm sure, that she went through ups and downs like all of us, she had the strength enough to still smile. She was born in Brooklyn, and she passed away in Brooklyn. There are a few things we can say about Musette Cox. First and foremost, although she was only 54 years old, we should thank God for her life in the first place. 54 is young. But look how much of an impact she had in 54 years. Three wonderful children, now grandchildren, friends who have come to speak on her behalf and testify how she impacted their lives. So we thank God for her life. And also we would say that she was someone that reminds us that even in death, the family should stick together. The family should hold on to each other. One of the hardest things, if not the hardest thing, any of us will go through is to lose our mother. And when we go through hurt like that, that's when the devil sees that we're vulnerable. And I would say that the family, hold on to each other, because there will be times where people will try to pick you apart on behalf of the devil. Stay together. Then the second thing is all the memories, based on all the pictures we find, and it says that she played basketball at Abraham Lincoln High School. And there are a lot of famous basketball players that have played for Abraham Lincoln High School. Sebastian Telfair and Lance Stevenson. And everybody knows about Stephon Marbury and his brothers, or Abraham Lincoln High School, but I will say this about Musette's basketball ability. Just the night before last at the Brooklyn Academy of Music, there was a great hoopla, well-deserved, for the WNBA draft. But without women like Musette Cox, perhaps there would not be a WNBA draft. She was a pioneer in that department. Even those who came before her, a bright smile, God gave her life. Hold on to all the precious memories. I would, even outside a church on Court Street, 66 Court Street, and we thank God for those from the DOE who are here, I would always see Musette Cox. And everybody, it seemed like everybody knew her, and she knew everybody. Right at the block, catty corner from McDonald's and Popeyes, Musette would come out, and everybody would rally around Musette, and she'd come out and go back in and do her work. She was about her business. Then, even in the fact that she had a severe ailment, and I would see her right here. She would make her way and sit right there in that first pew, knowing that she was sick, but she would find her way to church. she would find her way to church. It reminds me of a story in the Gospels about a woman who they said had an issue of blood. And no matter how severe that issue was, she worked her way through the crowd just to touch the hem of Jesus' garment. She was that determined to worship her God in her church. I would say for those who don't have a church, be like Musette and find your way to church. You don't have to find your way to church every Sunday, but it's good to have a church that will support you and cover you, because we don't know what's going on these days. 2 weeks ago, an earthquake. Last week, an eclipse. Next few days, the moon is going to turn pink. We don't know what that's about, but we do know that God is trying to say something. And I don't know what God is trying to say, but you know what God is trying to say in your life. So hold yourselves accountable and worship God, no matter what you call him. Worship this God who has all power. She worked her way to church. She had a bright smile. And we know that God is speaking. But last but not least, Imani, she kept the faith. Andre Donovan, she kept the faith. And if she can keep the faith, then you can keep the faith. The entire family will keep the faith. Right there on Park Avenue, right? Musette was high class. She lived on Park Avenue. You'll get that later on. And there are a lot of famous people and a lot of people that come from Park Avenue. Marcy, Tracy Morgan, everybody knows Jay-Z. But my favorite person from Marcy is Musette Cox. May God ever bless her in the name of Jesus. We're going to ask the funeral directors to come. I believe there will be a final viewing, and we'll govern ourselves accordingly. And the ushers will direct you when to come. Let the church say amen.
Ms. Gant said Musette was a strong member. And I'm glad to say family, friends, Brown Memorial Baptist Church, though I've come here several times over the years, often with a family that just want to use the church for space, I'm glad to be in your presence. Musette is a member. On behalf of the family, I want to take this moment, I will be brief, want to take this moment to say thank you for your presence. It means a lot to the family. To our Minister of Music, David Sales, thank you. To the pulpit, thank you. To all those who participated on the program, the person that's doing the live stream, thank you. I want to say thank you to Reverend Clinton. I see him often when I come here for a funeral. Miss Gant did mention, and hope she doesn't mind, that you were on funerals of loved ones. I just want to bless you all just for this moment. Musette children, they all know now how I feel about them. Yes. Yeah. I'm going to ask this young man to just say something, and that's what I want to give to you. Immediately following his last word, we're going to go back to the casket, and as Reverend Clinton mentioned, you'll be directed for the parting view. If you don't want to come, then they'll go to the next row. When we get to the family, please keep your seats. We'll come to the last row and bring you up. When we close the casket, we are asking that those who are going to be pallbearers to meet us in the rear of the sanctuary, please. And as already mentioned, the family invites you all for a repast. Family, join the repast. It's something about breaking bread, that first meal after a service. God bless you.
I hope this blesses you. Love me. Love me now. Right here for the right now. I won't tell you how to love me, just that you love me while I can still love you back. And please, give me my flowers today, because bouquets smell and look their best on Tuesdays and hump days. Let's take long, intimate walks through the park before my legs are cut down like the very same flowers you meant to give me yesterday. I need your love like yesterday. Don't wait until tomorrow when we're all gathered in sorrow, singing church songs down by the grave. Not even tears can express all the words that we could not say. So let us laugh and play and enjoy today and cry tomorrow. Pain always was a hard pill to swallow. Besides, love only hurts when it goes away, so make sure that it's real and it's here to stay. Will you love me in the fall the way you did in the summer, when my leaves start to change color and my texture may not last through the winter? We don't have much time, it's already the third day of September. Or will that twinkle in your eye under moonlit sky be the only thing that I remember? Or will I see you once more when the clocks turn back in the month of November? Love me harder, lift me up, draw me nearer, ration me, love me passionately, ever so tenderly. Love me now, right here for the right now, agape style. Thank you.
Will all except the family please stand? I heard a voice from heaven saying, unto me write, blessed are those that die in the Lord. They shall soon see the Spirit. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God and God's wise providence to take out this world, our beloved sister, Musette Cox, we therefore commit a body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. We shall look forward to the general resurrection and the life of the world to come through our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Shall we pray? And now, eternal God, we ask that you would open your wide gates of heaven, allow your child to come in. The family is saying goodbye, but we know that she's saying hello. We thank you for her life and her Christian witness, an advocate of education, an advocate for her family, and yes, a lover of Jesus Christ. So we ask, oh God, that you would keep us as we leave this place, but never from your presence. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
It's a video.